Paramahamsa Nityananda, a compelling spiritual force of our millennium, founder of an international socio-spiritual movement, pioneer of a modern Vedic Renaissance. Born in the sacred town of Tiruvannamalai, a yogi by birth, fearless spiritual explorer, beacon of divine power, Paramahamsa Nityananda is today an inspiration for millions on the path. Adept in ancient mystical yogic sciences, researcher of the science of spirituality, guru for enlightenment. Every year, Paramahamsa Nityananda shares with over 1 crore people worldwide the treasures of his wisdom, the joy of his laughter, and the incomparable power of his initiation. Now, Paramahamsa Nityananda reveals the deeper secrets of life, science of life. Join us every day for an unforgettable spiritual experience.
प्रदं देवं क्षमापूर्णं जगद्गुरुं वंदे परमहंसाख्यं नित्यानन्दाय स्वागतं जीवन् मुक्तिप्रदं देवं क्षमापूर्णं जगद्गुरुं वंदे परमहंसाख्यं नित्यानन्दाय स्वागतं आनन्दानुभवास्वादं सर्वरोगनिवारकं वंदे पापविनाशकं नित्यानन्दाय स्वागतम्।
इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ फीलिंग कनेक्शन, हाउ द फीलिंग कनेक्शन to something which is higher than you nullifies all the constant harassment you go through from your body and mind. Please understand, just before the satsang I was reading a question from a devotee. The person is telling, Swamiji, after all a physical pain is so solid, it constantly reminds itself, it is so strong. How to unclutch from it? It constantly reminds itself to us. Understand? There are problems which may not be solved by unclutching, will be solved by feeling connection. That is why I always warn you, people with whom you feel connected, you should be very careful. If you are friendly with a person depressed, I tell you, knowingly or unknowingly, that person will vomit the depression on you. If somebody is depressed, boycott that person. No, I am giving you as a spiritual instruction. Don't ever think you will show and shower your compassion on that person, shower your love on that person, get that person out of depression. Try, you will only become dirty and come back. You are not that strong. If you are that strong, then you don't even need to talk to the person. Your presence will get that person out of depression. No, I am telling you really, because a lot of this effort of getting the other person out of depression goes on all over. I wanted all of you to know, the problems which you can't heal, the pains which you can't get out by unclutching, get out only by feeling connection with something higher than you, either God or Guru, and ensure that you don't have feeling connection, you are not entertaining friendliness with people who are depressed or the patterns of depression. See, the people with patterns of depression are arrogant, I tell you. It is not ignorance or innocence, it is a crime. It is a crime, arrogant. Because they are arrogant, they will naturally infiltrate you even if you spend little time with them. I always warn. There's a beautiful teaching from Sri Ramakrishna. I always warn the disciples, warn the followers. If your spouse is in depression, don't try to get her out by yourself. If your friend is in depression, don't try to get him out by yourself. He will only put that depression mental setup in you. Help them to feel connected to something which is higher than them, to God or Guru. Stop with that. You don't try, you don't meddle with it. One more thing, especially a man trying to get a woman out of depression or a woman trying to get a man out of depression is very, very dangerous. Because when you sit with women or a man, when a man sits with women or a woman sits with man, understand, even if the age difference is 50, a 15-year-old boy is sitting with 65-year-old lady, I tell you, your Mooladhara will be open. By the very biology, your Mooladhara will be open. If that 65-year-old lady puts some idea to you, when you are in the mood of receptive, you are destroyed. Never ever sit with a person who is depressed. Never ever try to get the person who is depressed out of depression. All you can do is connect that person with a higher source, Guru or God, and move out. If you try to clean the drainage, you will become dirty by getting into it. The only way to clean the drainage is put the pipe and put the motor. Let the machines do the job. I have seen so many fellows. Ramakrishna used to tell this. Even in the name of compassion or helping or assisting. See, Ramakrishna had one disciple, Yogananda. He's a small boy. One elderly lady, around 45 or 50, she used to be always depressed, and this boy will try his best to get her out of depression by telling whatever ideas he learned from Sri Ramakrishna, or trying with all the ideas he learned. She will also treat him like a son. Ramakrishna calls and tells, no, no, this is the way it will start. You don't know how it will destroy you. Her pattern of depression will simply infiltrate you. And not only that, this sympathy which you can't help will extend to any extent, any level, and you will take up this as your mission, getting her out of the depression as your mission. With that, you will fall into the depression. Ramakrishna says very clearly. Then the Yogananda says, no, 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 no. I only see her as my mother. Ramakrishna says, no. I know how the mind works. In Chaitanya's history, Sri Krishna Chaitanya, a great master from West Bengal, in his biography, one of his close disciples, he kicks him out of his sangha just for the only one reason. He was sitting and talking with a woman. That's it. Nothing else. He investigated. He said, no, 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 she's in depression. I wanted to help her out. Chaitanya said, Mahaprabhu said, no, don't do. Put her directly in touch with Guru or God. You leave. Don't do. But this fellow did not listen. He said, his compassion is more powerful than the Guru. In 2 days, he kicked them out. And in a month, both of them had started having affair. In a year, both of them killed each other. Please understand. Killed each other. She gave poison to him. And without knowing, he has taken the poison to food, he has murdered her. She gave poison food to him. He ate, but he did not know he ate the poisoned food. He was waiting to kill her. He killed her. Then he died. The depression mental setup is worse than a snake. Run away from it. Because it will penetrate you very mildly only. It will be shared, dumped. And these depressed fellows are also so arrogant. They don't want to be all alone in depression. They want friends. They want friendliness. They want more and more support for their depression. What will be the reason for the depression? Especially in spiritual communities. Fighting with Sangha, fighting with Master, fighting with Dharma. That's all. Fighting with Buddha, Dhamma, Sangha, that's all. That's the only reason for depression. Arrogance. You will justify your fight. You will justify it in a very logical way, humble, arrogant way. I know it is my arrogance, it is my ego. Then why it should be all only one solution for everybody? Why can't we have a different solution for different people? When you know you are arrogant and depressed, get out. What right you have to judge the methods used by the master? Understand, depressed fellow is not just sick fellow, is a sin fellow. The only way for that extraordinary pains, the pains you can't handle by unclutching, can be healed by this beautiful word, matparaha. Bhagavan is using this word as a technique. He spoke about unclutching in last few verses. Now he is telling whatever can't be healed by the unclutching, the only way is matparaha. Tani sarvani samyamma yukta asida matparaha vashehi yasya indriyani tasya pranya pratishtita. Whether you believe it or not, whether you want to understand or not, you are a person, you are an individual soul reflecting pure consciousness, and you have to get up, that's all. You have to wake up. That's all. Let you all achieve, experience, live, express, radiate and share the eternal bliss. Nityananda. Thank you.
Welcome to Inner Awakening, the most powerful personal transformation retreat you could ever experience. In just 21 days, thousands are already experiencing the shortest route to constantly high energy levels, visible anti-aging, healing of chronic diseases, fulfilling relationships, and higher states of consciousness. What is the secret behind this transformation?
Kundalini means the inner potential energy. Once it is awakened, opens the different doors for the conscious experience in you. I can say which is a master key for all extraordinary spiritual experiences.
This extraordinary program is conducted personally by Paramahamsa Nityananda in the vibrant atmosphere of Nityananda Dhyanapeetam Ashram. Open yourself to the benefits of Nitya Yoga and practical meditation. Experience physical and mental healing. Discover simple ways to handle life with success. Above all, enjoy individual darshan and blessings from Paramahamsa Nityananda every day. Take 21 days for yourself and carry home the transformation of a lifetime.